Now this question, it was again asked by one of my students. And the question says, let Z1, Z2 and Z3 be three distinct complex numbers satisfying mod Z1 equals mod Z2 equals mod Z3 equals 1. Then which of the following is or are true? Now the first one is, if argument of Z1 upon Z2 is equal to pi by 2, then argument of Z minus Z1 upon Z minus Z2 is greater than pi by 4 when mod of Z is greater than 1. Now we know that since mod Z1 equals mod Z2 equals mod Z3 is equal to 1. So that means Z1, Z2 and Z3, they will lie on a unit circle whose center is at origin. Now for this first option, we'll consider two points Z1 and Z2 such that angle between Z1 and Z2 is pi by 2. So say this is Z1 and this is Z2, and angle between Z1 and Z2 is pi by 2. Now if we'll take any point on the circle, then we know that angle at the segment is half the angle at the center. So that means if this angle is 90, then this angle will be pi by 4. Now we'll take any point Z which is greater than 1. That means any point which lies outside this circle. So if we'll take any point which lies outside this circle, say Z, and in that case, if we'll look at this angle, this angle, it should be less than pi by 4. So as Z increases, the angle decreases. So this angle, it should be less than pi by 4 and not greater than pi by 4. So that means option A is incorrect. Now we look at option number 2. Now it is given that mod of Z1 is equal to 1. So if I'll square it, I'll write mod of Z1 square is equal to 1. Then Z1 bar is equal to 1. So I can write 1 upon Z1 as Z1 bar. So in the same way, I can write 1 upon Z2 as Z2 bar and 1 upon Z3 as Z3 bar. Now if I'll add all these three, then I'll write 1 upon Z1 plus 1 upon Z2 plus 1 upon Z3, and this is Z1 bar plus Z2 bar plus Z3 bar. Now, if the two complex numbers are equal, then their modulus are also equal. So that means mod of 1 upon Z1 plus 1 upon Z2 plus 1 upon Z3, and this is mod of Z1 bar plus Z2 bar plus Z3 bar. Now, I'll take the LCM on the left hand side. I'll write 1 upon Z2, Z3, Z3, Z1, Z1, Z2 upon Z1, Z2, Z3, and this is conjugate of Z1 plus Z2 is conjugate of Z1 plus conjugate of Z2. So I'll write it as Z1 plus Z2 plus Z3 conjugate. Now modulus of Z1 upon Z2 is mod Z1 upon mod Z2. In the same way, mod of Z1 into Z2 is mod of Z1 into mod of Z2. So from here I can write mod of Z2, Z3 plus Z3, Z1 plus Z1, Z2 upon mod Z1, mod Z2, mod Z3, and we also know that mod of Z bar equals mod of Z. So I'll write mod of Z1 plus Z2 plus Z3. Now it is given that mod Z1, mod Z2, mod Z3 is 1. So this is 1. So then we can say option number B is correct. That is mod of Z1, Z2 plus Z2, Z3 plus Z3, Z1 is equal to Z1 plus Z2 plus Z3. Now we'll come to this third part. So we are given Z1 plus Z2, Z2 plus Z3, Z3 plus Z1 upon Z1, Z2, Z3, and we need to find if its imaginary part is 0. So what we'll do is, I'll divide first one with Z1, second with Z2 and third with Z3. So I'll write 1 plus Z2 upon Z1, 1 plus z3 upon z2, and this is 1 plus z1 upon z3. Now we know that all these z1, z2 and z3, they lie on a unit circle. So that means we can simply say z1 is sum e to the power iota theta 1, z2 is sum e to the power iota theta 2, and z3 is e to the power iota theta 3. Now we can write it as 1 plus, this is e to the power iota theta 2 minus theta 1, this is e to the power iota theta 3 minus theta 2, and this is 1 plus e to the power iota theta 1 minus theta 3. Now from the first expression, I'll take e to the power iota theta 2 minus theta 1 by 2 common. From the second one, I'll take e to the power iota theta 3 minus theta 2 by 2. And from the third one, I'll take e to the power iota theta 1 minus theta 3 by 2. So if I'll take them common, I'll write e to the power iota theta 1 minus theta 2 by 2 e to the power minus iota theta 2 minus theta 1 by 2, and then plus e to the power iota theta 2 minus theta 1 by 2. In the same way for the second one, I'll write e to the power iota theta 3 minus theta 2 by 2, and here I'll get e to the power minus iota theta 3 minus theta 2 by 2, and then plus e to the power iota theta 3 minus theta 2 by 2, and then into e to the power iota theta 1 minus theta 3 by 2, and here I'll get e to the power minus iota theta 1 minus theta 3 by 2 plus e to the power iota theta 1 minus theta 3 by 2. Here it should be theta 2 minus theta 1. Now if I'll take these three together, in that case, sum of powers will be 0. So it will be simply e to the power iota 0. And then here it is e to the power minus iota theta and e to the power iota theta, which is cos theta minus iota sin theta, and then plus cos theta plus iota sin theta. In this case, iota sin theta will cancel. So here I'll get 2 cos theta 2 minus theta 1 by 2. For the second one, it'll be 2 cos theta 3 minus theta 2 by 2, and then here will be 2 cos theta 1 minus theta 3 by 2. So e to the power 0 iota is simply 1. So in that case, this expression is a real number. So if this expression is a real number, then its imaginary part will be simply 0. So that means option C is also correct. Now we look at option number D. Now we look at these three complex numbers, z1, z2 and z3. It says mod of z1 minus z2. So suppose if this is a, b and c, so we know that it is given that ab is equal to root 2, and z1 minus z3, z1 minus z3 is ac, and z2 minus z3 is bc. So this is root 2 bc. So we are given the condition that ab is root 2 times AC and root 2 times BC. So that means AC and BC, they're equal. And suppose this is K, then AB is simply root 2K. So which simply means this triangle ABC is a right angle triangle at C. B is Z2 and C is Z3. So if this angle is 90 degrees, then we can write argument of Z3 minus Z1 upon Z3 minus Z2 is pi by 2. Now, when the argument of any complex number is either pi by 2 or minus pi by 2, we know that that complex number is purely imaginary. So that means Z3 minus Z1 upon Z3 minus Z2 is purely imaginary. And if it is purely imaginary, then it simply means its real part will be 0. So that means option number D is also correct. So option A is incorrect, but option B, C, and D, they are correct.